Darren, let's try replit, okay? I have opened a new team. Now you can share your screen. I'm going to give you two links, okay? And let's see which one works, okay? Okay, let's check this one. This one. Right. Teams. Manage. Try this. Find replicability, okay? There. Here. If it works, then it's okay. But if it doesn't work, we will try this one. Okay. Yeah, try the first link and then share screen, okay? We're going to start cryptography lessons, okay? Okay, let me check. Nice. There you go, then. Aaron, yes. No, first demo string and list manipulation. Okay, just experiment and run there. It will show you how it works, basically. Type a string. Hi. Okay, the girl too. Huh? Oh. Probably longer sentence. Or supposed to work. Okay. Hello. Oh, that's why, Darren. See. How about hello? Okay. When we have like 5 letters, then the index supposed to be from 0 to 4. So you say hello, give index less than 5. If you say hi, the index is only 1, 0, and 1. There. There you go. It is about how to manage string. And yes. Try submit. If you cannot, you just move to the next lesson, okay? Let me check. I'm going to check on this, on replit here. Nice. Wow, this is nice. Can you submit it? Okay, nice. Nice, Darren. You can, as long as you have understand all the instruction, then we can move on to the next lesson because it's going to be harder. Oh, okay. Yes, you have to do all num. Yeah. So each one, each time you forget the command, just take a look at the demo, the example on the demo. Right. Okay. Don't forget about the index. It is start from 0, not from 1. Return the character at index 2 in string S, which I'll remind you is not the second character. So, question 1. Return. Oh, so like, okay, like this there. Wait, I'm going to copy paste the. Okay, wait. I will give you a snippet of example, okay? From the cryptography, this one. Demonstrating and manipulation on main. Wait. So, wait. Main. Input. Okay. Like this there. You can try this. Do we have to put it on functions? This is the example. Please type a string and then input, please type an integer num, and then we will print the num. Return the character at to string. Return, oh, like this, Darren, like this. Wait. Let me write. Return. S index 2. Like this, I think. Yes. Without quotes. Without quotes. Okay. Just run it, and then what happened? There. Oh, okay. So the first string is X, okay, an index X. Oh, a big. Okay. Okay, Darren. Try the next. Yep. Return the fifth character. Oh, index 2. Also, this is supposed index 2, so this is supposed to be 2. Right? And then as the fifth character. The fifth character is supposed to be index 4. Okay. Number 3. Number 3, len s. Number 4, how to make this? I want to make it len with, oh, can I? Can I make it number 2, number 3? Return the first character. So the first character is supposed to be this. It's number 1, number 2, number 3. I'm sorry, I'm messing your screen. It's okay, Darren. Return the last character. Okay, how to return the first character? So it's supposed to be len. Oh. S, if we can do it, len S, minus 1. Return depend on with ultimate character. So S, if this works, I don't know. Okay, len S minus 2. Okay, just try it out, Darren. Just try to run it and then see if we got this right for six first. Okay, the length. See, right. Hah? Kok yang pertama A sih? ABC. Oh, bukan ABC ya. Okay. It's probably something else, right? Something not alphabet, all the alphabet. Okay. The first is A. The fourth is P. The length is 13. And then the first is X, okay? The last is G, and then before G is O, N. Okay, I think this is correct. I think. What do you think? Okay, I'm going to clear up this. Let's start number 7. Number 7. What? Substring starting 5 character long substring starting at index 3. Substring. Wait, I forgot about substring. Substring, it's supposed to be, oh, like this. How about, wait, Darren. Oh, wait. Insert 3 substring. Okay. Wait, I'm going to find you an example. Substring in part 1. Yeah, you go, there you go, like this. Aaron, I'm going to send you on the chat, okay? String. Like this, there on the chat. So, if you want to return 5 character long substring starting at index 3, we have to say as the start. We start from index 3. 3 berarti ya. 5. 1 gitu ya. Gitu ya, Darren, benar nggak? I think that. Return. String in this must be integers. Iya kan integers ini. 35 sama 1. What's wrong? Let me check, basic usage. String and start. Oh, we have to use this, Darren. I forgot. Wait. I'm going to delete. We have to write it like this. S. Three. Ya kan mulai dari 3 ya. Tadi lupa berapa? Ya dari 3. Titik 2, Darren. Titik 2, not semicolon. Okay. Yep. Try it, run it. Huh? Start M. Wait. Five character long substring. Oh, at index 3. So, 3 tambah 5 berarti 8 dong ya, gini ya. Tambah 5 berarti, salah ya kita ya. Itu substring 5 karakter. Oke, 5 karakter enggak? Iya. Oh, examples. I think this is going okay. Next apa? Itu nomor berapa? 7, nomor 8. Return the story concept last 5 characters of the string. Gimana, Darren? Cara Darren gimana? Ada cara yang beda loh. Ntar kecil gak lupa. Kita tuh bisa ngambil the, ini. Kayak gini. Ntar ya, kasih contoh di ini ya. Ini the last one. Kayak gini, Darren. So, if you have the string like this, you can print it just like this. Minus 5. And then, tik 2. Berarti kalau gitu, kita bisa S minus 5 titik 2 itu the last 5 string ya gitu. Yes, right. Oke, nomor 9, nomor 9. Coba, bener nggak? Iya, string ya. String. I think we have to figure out all the string at the end of it. Return the original string in lowercase. Ayo, ingat nggak? Nomor berapa sekarang? Nomor 9 ya. Return the substring starting at the character at index 3 and continuing to the end of the string. Ayo, mulai gimana? Gini. Ntar, mulai dari 3 sampai selesai ya. 3 sampai selesai. Lupa ya gimana ya? Ntar, 3 sampai selesai itu berarti get substring for character long. Get the last character of the string minus 1. Kalau misalnya, oke. Okay. How to get certain index of the string to the end in Python. Lupa, bentar ya. Bentar itu, lanjut dulu, bentar. Lupa, kalau yang N itu gimana ya? Storm N. Beginning N. Atau gini coba. Coba-coba gini. Coba ganti warna ya. Yang ngebushen. Gini coba. Kita mulai dari, katanya berapa, Dan? At index 3. Coba kalau gini gimana? Bisa nggak? Sampai akhir. Tapi nggak akhir ya. Nggak akhir ya. Paling akhir G ya. The last index. The last tuh min 1. The last. Except, I know. Get the substring contents of character. Except the last for characters. Okay, berarti bener, depannya benar 3. Every other character from string itu lewat 2. Berarti kalau mau sampai akhir, get the last character itu minus 1. Berarti kalau gitu, kalau 0 gimana, Darren? Cobain dong misalnya 3,0 gitu. Belakangnya harus G kan? Bener kan? Bener kan? Tapi dia bilang dari posisi 3 ya. At index 3 and continuing. Taruh dia itu gimana sih? Start and step. Oh, berarti kalau gitu startnya 0. Startnya 3. N-nya 0. Udah bener kan? Stepnya 1. Mau dikasih 1 gini. Gitu. Kayak 3,0,1 gitu coba. Darin. Oh, mau gitu. Ini sama ya? Sama ya? Tapi harusnya panjang atuh. Coba 9 nggak keluar ya? Ini Darren yang ini. Oh iya nggak keluar ya. Gimana caranya ya? 3. Coba 3, 13, 1 coba Darren. Kita kan udah tahu licik panjangnya 13 kan. Empol string ya. Ya udah. Berarti itu. Tapi harusnya ada cara lain. Gimana? Gimana caranya? Caranya lupa. Ya udah, biar lu. Alright, sekarang nomor 10. Nomor 10. Kita coba nomor 10. Return original string in lowercase. Ingat nggak, Danan? Lowercase. Masih ingat nggak? Aku hapus dulu. Lowercase itu kalau di Python, kalau nggak salah, mana? Salah. Ini salah. Yuk. Gini, Danan. Kalau misalnya mau... Oh, ini kepin. Salah, sorry. Berarti kita gini. S lower, coba print S lower. Itu nomor 10, nomor 11, S upper. Gitu. Titik. Titik bukan bukan dash. This is a dot. Yes. Dot sayangku. Titik. Nah, yang bawahnya juga. Yes, cobain print dulu. Nah kan, bener kan? Ih, oh cuman segini. Loh, ntar dulu, kok ini ada 13 ya? 13 simple string itu berapa huruf sih simple string? 11. Kok ada angka 13 sih? Kita ngetik apa? 13. How do we get 13? Example string. Oh, panjangnya ya, the length ya. Oh, ya, got it. Okay, sekarang Darren, nomor 12 coba gimana? Convert the string to a list and return the list. Hah, convert the string to a list. Convert a string to a list. Oh, tunggu contoh ya. I'm going to give you an example, okay? Okay. Is this using? Cari yang gampang dulu. Gimana ya? String convert. Wait, jangan yang susah. Kita tadi diajarin nggak sih Darren pakai caranya? Oh, okay. Kayaknya ini deh yang paling oke. Cobain Darren. Ini deh kayaknya. Ya, di chat ya. Jadi, X sama dengan E for E in S, print X. Ini nih, yang contoh yang terakhir ya. I have sent you. But I'm going to check on replit if they have oh, benar. Ya, kayak gitu. Dan just exactly. We'll just let's like, cut out tuh kayak gitu. After inserting tuh gitu. Append to the list. First index. Oke, bisa. Okay, bisa nggak? Yeah. Just like I gave you, so you have to return. Iya gitu, nggak gitu. Langsung aja x sama dengan. Just type in the x equals to. We don't yes from there. Bisa nggak ya gitu ya? E for E in S. So for everything inside S, we will print you print it in list. In S print X. Gimana ya? Gitu aja. Bisa nggak ya dia nge-print gitu? Mau gak ya? Coba di run. Error nggak? Bukan nggak bisa ya. Return. Oh, I know. Coba minjem dulu deh. I'm going to do it. Okay, like this. So, yes. So we are going to move it. Move this. Okay, dihapus dulu ya. Ini. Jadi kan kita punya S. So that we have. Okay. So that we have S given S. And then X is equal anything for E in S. Return X. Eh, bisa gitu nggak? There! Example string. Oke, okay, benar, Darren. Nice. So, do you know the difference between string and list? When we have string, we have the whole characters all together like this. Yeah, yes, Darren. So when we put in on a list it has a form like this. It has square brackets, and then it will list all the elements separated by comma. So this is basically the list. The list can be anything. Can be a letter. Can be a word. Like Darren, probably it can be Darren, a word, or an integer, or a number, a fraction of numbers. So we can have basically can have a list of different elements or list of the same elements, and the list is infinite. You can put as many element in the list. Okay, so that's the difference between string and list. Why do we have to change it? Because we want to see clearly the index. Okay, now number 13. Okay, return this. Oh, okay. Okay, what do you think, Darren? We want to shift the character one to the right. So, okay, in example, the original string with the last character removed. So if I have this word, let's say I have this word cats, I want it to be ATS. Oh, no. Shift to the right, so we lost the last one. So we want to be like this, Darren. How to do this? We remove the last one. So it's like when you have when you are watching, or you when you are watching a movie and sitting on your seat, and it's the index seat number 0, seat number 1, seat number 2, and seat number 3, and then we have like this cats, and then we shift it to the right. C becomes on the A becomes on the T, and T move to the S, and S is being kicked out the cinema. So we want to do it like that. Okay, any idea, Darren, how to do it? How to make it like that? How to shift it to the right? Level 2 kinda tricky. Okay, ini number 13 emang tricky. Gimana caranya, coba, Darren? But so we have to change. We have to change the index. So the first thing to do is, let me check if we have they have give us example. Bentar ya, ada nggak ya di sini? Dia udah kasih contoh belum ya? Use the command how to shift right. How to shift right. Okay, let us check. Oh, I'm going to find you the simplest one. Okay, this is too difficult. Can we do it in an easy way? Join rotate. Oh, okay. we split it and then wait there, let me think. Oh, sushi. Sushi. Oh, this is nice. Oh, this is nice. Not too hard. Working with single character. So, basically, apa manual aja ya? Kalau manual kan gini ada, if you, we do it manually, and then how about kita kan punya segini ya, we have tadi kan karakter yang kita punya segini ya, Darren ya, oh we have 13 ya, 13 characters ya kan, 13 characters, apa sih isinya, example string ya, example sample sample string ya kalau nggak salah isinya sample sample benar nggak sih ya kan ya example string ih salah aku oke andu ntar ya daftar gambar dulu ya Darren ya bentar ya kita kan punya example string ini ya example string. Dia tuh awalnya gimana sih tulisannya? Gede ya, gini ya. Example string gini ya. Terserah lah ya, pokoknya ada S-nya. Example string. Berarti kan kita punya 4. We have 13 seat, right? Index from 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sorry, 6 yang mana sih? Ini ya, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Bener kan ya, 12 karena 13 ya. Nah, sekarang kita maunya geser. We want to shift it there. We want it to be like this. We want it to be E. The index should be 1. And so are the others like this. Bener kan deh geser kanan kan? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Nah, si ini udah gak ada nih karena dia gak punya indeksnya kan. Indeksnya maksimum 12 ya. The maximum is 12. So we want to remove the last one. How do we do that? How do we do that? Bisa gini sih, ntar ya, coba ya. I'm going to code on my own replit ya, coba ya. Misalnya I have stringnya apa sih? Tunggu. Atau di sini Darren. Kita bisa buka baru nggak sih? Tar. I'm going to make a new replit. New replit. How about I am opening a new replit better. Replit. Coba ya. Berarti kan geser satu ya. My replit. I'm going to make my own. Where is my Python? Okay, this one. My screen, okay. Take a look at my screen. I'm going to do this. Simple sorting. Okay. Kita coba ini berarti ya. Let's say kita punya karakter example. Ini. Tes dulu ya. Print plan S gitu ya. Let's check. Panjangnya 13 nggak? Ya. Panjangnya benar ya 13 ya. Dah. Sekarang kan berarti indeks ya. Nah, indeksnya berarti kan example string. We want berarti kalau yang tadi gimana kan? Lupa. Yang chat gimana? Oh, X ya. Nah, ya, kalau ini kita jadiin ini ya. Ini kan kalau kita if we want it to be list, right? Let's say diginiin ya. Biar kelihatan kan Darren.
So we know exactly that they occupy one seat for each letter like that.
Now we want it to be shifted to the right. So we are going to for x. Okay, for anything p for e in x. Oh, I know. Or we can do, wait. We shift it to the right. So shift it to the right. So we will have. Nah, tapi ya, kalau misalnya kita geser ke kanan, if we shift all to the right, so that we have to insert zero on the first seat, right? Jadi kalau misalnya kita punya gini, benar nggak sih, Darren? Let me think. Let me know what you think. Yeah. If we have like this, kan? We have this, like three seats, four. Okay, cats like that, right? Cats, and then why is it too big? Okay, cats. This is index 0, 1, 2, 3. We want it to be like this, shifted to the right. So that means the first seat will be empty, right? So it's either we move the S to the first seat or let it empty, okay? Okay, now let's just do this one, okay? So what do you have in mind, Darren? I think we have to say that for the first, okay. We will, let's say, to make it clear, then jangan, but when mikir ya, ingetin ya, ya. I'm going to add, kan kalau S kan ini kan, S kan isinya ini ya, Darren. Example string kan. Kalau X isinya apa? X isinya list kan ya, Darren ingetin. I'm going to make another. Misalnya namanya apa, Darren? Misalnya A. Nah, A itu, jadi ini misalnya ini X ya. Ini X atau S lah ya. I'm going to make it to be A. A is a shifted, character. Jadi berarti di sini kita bikin untuk semua yang ada di X, A itu, berarti A, gimana, Darren, gimana? Where are you writing the A? Nggak usah langsung aja, we just add it now. We are adding it now. Berarti for E, berarti A0 itu adalah isinya X1, benar nggak? A yang ada di E, A with index E is the next one. Gitu nggak, Darren? Do you get it? Dapat nggak, Darren, idenya? Jadi gini, tapi itu geser kiri ya. Ini example aja, Darren, ya. Let me know ya. Kasih tahu ya, chat aja ya. Kan kita punya X sama A, kan? Nah, terus kita mau geser, kan? Nah, ini tuh bilang bahwa ini kan I-nya kan berarti for semua yang ada di dalam X, kan? X-nya kan isinya cats ya. Jadi untuk semua yang ada di X, kita tuh mau geser gitu. Nah, berarti kan si I ini ngitungnya tuh mulai dari 0. It will count from 0 to 4, right? Because we have, no. We have 0 to 3. Because we have 4 seats, right? Then, I'm going to say that we, for A, untuk kursi yang 0, itu tuh diisi dengan X di posisi yang sebelahnya gitu. Jadi nanti ya si A0 ini kan 0, 1, 2 gitu ya. Nah, ini tuh diisi sama yang berikut ya, tapi tuh jadi geser kiri, ini jadi A, ini jadi T, ini jadi S gitu loh. Darren, kebayang gak? Coba lihat chat, ya, Darren. Oh, you see on my screen share, Darren, I'm not writing on your screen. See my screen share. I'm sharing my screen. Stop your screen and then see my screen. Because if I mess up with your replit, I'm afraid it will be messed up. And okay, can you see it? Oh, okay, already nice. See there, I'm going to move it. So I'm going to make sure that okay. Wrong button. Okay, I'm going to start again. First, we have this. We have this S, all right? S is a string, right? And then when I print, we have this example string. But I'm going to make another variable, which is X. X is a list, which is this one. This one is X, right? What we want to do is to shift the position, right? Like if we have like this, Darren, we have, let's say we only have 4 seats. So we only have cats like this. We want it to be shifted to the right. So the C, this is the index, right? Okay. We want the C to be the index 1, like this. The A to be the index 2 from index 1. And then the T to be on index 3 from index 2, right? So this one will be removed because we don't have enough seat left, right? So it's either we can remove this S or put the S back to the first position. We can do it. It's called a right circular shift. So that's you shift it circularly, so you don't lose anything. So you don't remove any characters, but it will. The character and the last position will be on the first position like that. So this is what I'm going to do. This is, let's say that this is X, right? I'm going to make another variable called A, which has this arrangement. So that this is the index. As you can see, for each letter, it will have different index, right? So this is what I'm going to do. Here, I'm going to say that for any index for A, it has to be, so a 0 on A should be the last character. I want to say it like this. The last character on the X. So the last character should be len X minus E. Oh, okay. Len A. I don't think this is correct already, but we just see, okay? Error, okay. For I in X, len X. We already have, okay. Let's say let's try this. Okay, example. We have, okay. I'm going to print X here so we can see the string. Okay, example string. Okay. And then we will have this A. What I know is to shift left, Darren. Kalau shift left lebih gampang. Jadi kalau A-nya itu di posisi 0, dia tuh ngambil posisi sebelahnya yang di X. Ya, misalnya I plus 1 gitu. Itu coba ya kita print ya. Nah, itu kalau geser kiri. Tapi kalau geser kanan lebih susah ya. Kalau ini jadi geser kiri nggak? Kok error ya? For E in X. Oh, we cannot do this. Alright. So kalau gitu aja boleh nggak sih? Pakai S aja ya. Pakai S aja kalau gitu nggak usah pakai X. Kok nggak mau juga ya? Berarti kan bisa ya.
E for E, E for E in S.
Ah.
Oh iya salah ya. A sama dengan.
Ah, berarti bisa gini.
Bisa gini. Border. This is tricky, tricky.
Oh, nggak mau ya. Syntax error. Oke, okay. Kalau nggak boleh pakai X, berarti pakai S boleh dong. Pakai S boleh nggak? List nggak boleh digituin ya. We cannot do it with list, right? Run. Hah, kok salah sih? A sama dengan I for I sum in S. Oh, sorry. Berarti ini boleh X. Darren, please let me know if I'm being stupid, okay? Oh, unexpected. Oh, yeah. Maaf. Oh, I know now. Oh, okay. For gini, berarti for E. Gini aja deh, for E in X. Nah, sekarang I know. Okay, I think this will work. For each. Tunggu ya, Darren. For A-I. Bentar ya, gimana caranya? Variabel barunya gimana ya? Kita bikin dulu A sama A gini deh. Gak boleh. A ini sama dengan gini. A sama dengan kosong. For E in X. A, posisi I itu sama dengan X posisi I plus 1. Bentar, Ren. Let me think. Why does it work? Kenapa ya? Can only concatenate string, not to integer. Oke, kalau gitu boleh nggak gini? Kalau nggak boleh itu, boleh nggak pakai string? Ini. Nggak boleh juga. Kalau A-nya string, boleh nggak? Nggak bisa juga ya. And only concatenate string, nothing. Okay, kita ngintip ini dulu, Darren. Kan dikasih contoh ya, we have examples here. Oh, wait. Oh, okay, in range. Wait. Okay, ya udah gini-gini kalau gitu. Range. Lengthnya berapa sih? Length S ya? Kita mau sepanjang S kan? Nah, gini aja berarti ya. Ya kan? Coba-coba ya. In range. Kok nggak boleh? Di sini boleh. Range in len. Wait, wait, wait. In for char in LST2. Ini kan boleh juga ya kayak gini. Coba-coba-coba. Gini. Kita ambil ini dulu yuk. Biar Darren gak bingung. Okay, I'm going to take this snippet. And then I'm going to put it in here. Ini di comment out dulu biar Darren gak pusing. Ini ya, kayak gini ya. Misalnya kita punya hey, what happened? Kenapa ya? Something is wrong katanya. Aneh, ih kenapa ya? Setelah gini. Ini dia aku suruh. Gini deh. I'm going to make a brand new code. I'm not messing up with the existing one. Okay, I'm going to run this. Error, kenapa ya, Darren? What's wrong? Alpha, A, A, B, C. Oh, okay. For character in, oh, in A. In A, let's say that. Nggak bisa sih. Tunggu, kenapa ya? For char in A, print, oh, ini. Gitu. Apa yang salah ya? Alpha. Oke, okay. For character in alpha, run. Oh, error ya, Darren. Coba yang ini jalan nggak? Nah, ini I'm going to clear up this ya. Karena dibersihin dulu, jangan nggak pusing, clear dulu. Clear on the wings. Nih ya. Kita run ini ya, Darren ya. Coba lihat ya. Lista pastry, Darren, integer, 3, oke. Okay. Tap a single character to search for, R. R tuh ada di situ ya, enter. Oke, okay, now A, B, C, D is index ini kan. Nah, ini kan udah ada ya. Kita bisa ngeprint si huruf-huruf ini kan, mulai dari yang besar sampai pendek. Sama indeks-indeksnya kan. Nah, I'm going to take this. Tunggu. Berarti tuh, what I want to do is, kita tuh bisa nggak sih nge-print deh. That's right. Okay. Boleh nggak sih kalau misalnya kita punya S gitu ya. S isinya apa dong, Darren? Kita bikin baru aja. A, B, C, D lah ya, biarin ya. Ini gini ya. Terus kita mau geser. Atau gini deh. Ini isinya cats aja lah. Cats gitu ya. Mau kita geser. Misalnya A itu berarti, misalnya A itu adalah, tunggu, itu adalah ini. Emang susah sih ini. Oke. Okay. X itu for ini. X. Oke, okay. Run dulu. Yaudah, ini nggak ada, ya udah saya nggak pakai ini deh, tuh. Oke, gini. Oke, ini kita print. Kita udah punya S kan, kita print S. Sekarang kita mau, oke, for E in X, gitu ya. Katakan misalnya kita punya A. A itu adalah list baru. Kalau di print kita nggak A. Ini kita pamerin dulu. Kita punya A kosong ya. Nah, ya. Sekarang kita punya A kosong. We have like empty seat, right, Darren? But we want to shift the letter one seat to the right, right? So I'm going to fill in the A with so I on the first position, I on the first position. Oh, okay, kalau gitu gini aja lah. For E in range, lengthnya S, gitu ya. Minus satu. Okay. A posisi yang ke nol atau A posisi ke nol ini kayaknya sih deh posisi nol itu sama dengan s posisi i plus satu atau x aja oke di sini print a ini gitu nggak sih Darren ini nggak bisa ya berarti ini s ya. Oke, okay. Minus 2 lah.
Okay, kalau gitu, ini rentnya berapa sih? Lainnya 4 lah ya. 4 kan nggak boleh, jadi sampai 3 ya. Ini boleh nggak sih, Darren? Saya 0. 0 isinya jadi 1. 1 jadi isinya 2. 2 isinya jadi 3, gitu kan? Kok nggak bisa ya? Coba-coba print S posisi 3. S posisi 3, 3 kan? Oke. Okay. Berarti kalau gitu, kalau misalnya A-nya diisi 0, berarti kan ini 0. Kalau 0 berarti ini diisi sama 1. Kalau 1 diisi sama 2. 2 diisi sama 3 kan? Ya nggak sih? Atau gini lah. Gini dulu. Atau nggak? Ih kok tetap sih? How copy from one list to another? This is really, really tricky. Sabar ya, Jaren. How do I calling or copy? Kenapa lemot gini ya? Nah, kayak gini kan ya? Oh, bisa di clone. Oke, kita pakai copy. Bisa pakai append, deep copy. Gimana ya cara ngopi aja ya, dan kita harus cuman gitu deh. Misalnya A ya, atau harus gitu sih, harus dikosongin gitu. Misalnya gini ya. Oh, I see. Ini jangan S, harusnya ini X. Coba kalau gini bisa nggak? Kok nggak bisa sih? Kok nggak mau ya? Cara ngopi dari isinya A ke X ke A gimana, Darren? Coba. Ada ide nggak? X sama dengan semua huruf yang ada di S kan dijadiin list ya. Berarti kan kalau gitu, kita kalau mau ngopi ke A, harusnya kan tinggal ngopi aja per index kan. We just add them by the index, right? Masa harus di cloning sih? Mau gitu. Tapi kan nggak diajarin gitu ya, harusnya nggak dong. Misalnya, masa gini sih? A sama dengan cloning X gitu. Emang bisa? Oh, cloningnya ini, copy extend. Oh, nggak mau gitu. I don't want that. Ya, emang ini tricky banget. This is really tricky. With their right? Cloning. Oh, I know. I have it before the call. Wait, Darren, I'm going to show you this. I'm going to give you the code as well. Probably, I don't know if it is too hard to understand. You can tell me, okay. And out, here. Wait, I have done this before on Python. Okay, Python, where's Python? Right, this one. Bentar, download dulu, Darren. Okay, here. Here we go. Set our cipher. I have done this before. Why does that it? Like this, Darren. See? This is, okay, I'm going to copy this and explain it to you, okay? So basically, what we've been doing is try to make a Caesar cipher that we shift the letter some numbers away. So like this. I already create this a print this. Print your okay there. So like this.
Okay, the code is like this. I will make sure this work, and I will copy it for you so you can run on your record. Wait. Darren, apa sih errornya? If si, oh oke. Okay. You know, I know what to do. Oke, okay. Ya. Oke, okay. Misalnya gini, plain text-nya kan, misalnya apa? Darren like that. Wow. Like that. And then when we run, do you know why the output is like this, Darren? Because the key is five. So when we have it five, it means that each character will be shifted five letters to the right. So if you examine it closely, the D in Darren will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will become I, right? A on Darren will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will become F. Do you get it, Darren? So all the R on Darren will be moved 5 to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It becomes WW. And the J and the E in Darren is E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It becomes J, and then N, and in Darren, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It becomes S. Okay. Okay. Do you understand how it works now? So, what we are going to do before was. I don't know why I cannot figure it out. It seems to be the same, but we have this list, okay? The plain text is the text we want to encrypt, and then the alphabet is like that. So when we say five, it will shift it to the right five letters, right? But if I say the K is the key is one, so it will just shift one letter to the right. So D will be E. A will be B, R will be S, R will be S, E will be F, N will be O, right? So what we are doing is like that. So if we say cat, it will be DBU, because C become D, A become B, T become U, right? Now, I'd like you to explain this. Tell me if you don't get it off, Darren. This is a little bit, but I want you to read, to understand more, but I'm going to give you the full picture that what we are doing here is. Okay, let me change the context. Let's say that word in the plain text for each word, we will replace it with the character in the alphabet that is in the position. Okay. Let me explain it in chat. So basically, this works by replacing every letter in the plain text with the correlated letter in alphabet based on how many times it is shifted to the right. The number of how many times it been shifted to the right is determined by K. So when you say the K should be like 10, so each word, each letter in this word will be shift 10 letters through the alphabet like that. So C will become everything. C will be something 10 letters away. So like C will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it will be M. So if we run this, the cat will be MKD. Okay. Is it clear enough, Darren? So if you see the code, it's probably a little bit confusing because this is the way we say that for every character in the plain text. And this is the way we say that if anything in the plain text is in the alphabet, we will replace it with the index plus decay. So this is how we add the index. So it works nicely. So when we say like example queen, and then we want to run it, then it will be encrypted like this example string. So basically, this is how we hide message. I used to do this when I was in elementary school, and I write something for my friend, a secret message. Cesar cipher is a very the easiest encryption or the easiest way to hide message. Okay, now the question, Darren. How do you revert this back to the original? Like when I say Darren, okay. And then we encrypt it like this. How we get it back this to Darren? How do you get it back? Like when we yes. Exactly, Darren. So let's say when we say hey, we shift it right, to the right. So if you want it to be back to Darren, what we do is we have to copy this to the plain text, and then we change it into negative. So from shifting right, now we are shifting left. So we will get it back. So that's how we do encryption and decryption. So this is how we do the code. I'm going to give this to you so you can try. Okay. Very smart, Darren. Okay, you understand. Okay, good. Now, we're going to get back here doing our lesson. Which one is it? Where's the, oh, okay, here. I forgot the question, Darren. We have to move it to the right. So we probably can copy this. Or we can, wait, I'm going to rename it to be on Replit. Oh yeah, Darren, in Replit, when you have a, you know, like this one file, it will run only the main file. So if you want to run a new file, you have to rename it. If you want to run the five this, you have to you rename it to be main page, because the one will be run with this main page. Okay, ini apa aja sih waktu itu bikin apa ya? Oke, okay, ya. Yeah. Oh, oke, okay. Sekarang now we get back here. We get back here. We have this S. And then we have these caps. And then we print. And then we print S. And then we have X. X is E. Ini lupa gimana tadi Darren, masih penasaran. I'm curious why doesn't it work with simpler example. Okay, we have X, okay, we have N, okay, we have S, and then we have X, and then I want to have A. Or E in range. Len X. Can I print this? Len Len X. Bisa nggak ya? Kayak gini. Oh, bisa kan 4 ya? Oke, okay, berarti kalau gitu for A in range Len X boleh dong? Kenapa nggak boleh sih? Jadi boleh nggak A I sama dengan X I gitu, boleh nggak? Oke, okay, udah marah. A-nya nggak ber A sama dengan ya udah A-nya gini. Oh bisa. Oh harus di define gitu. Harus sama panjangnya. We have to define exactly the same. The same size. So let me print A now. Coba ya. Okay, now we have A is exactly the same with X, right? So I'm going now. We have to shift it to the right, right? So I'm going to now for E in range len X minus 1. I berarti kalau A-nya, gimana sih Darren kalau geser ke kiri ke kanan tuh jadi gimana sih? Jadi gede apa jadi kecil sih? Berarti kan kalau caps jadi besar kan? Oh. For R in range berarti mulainya dari minus 1 sampai len X. Ini 1 gitu kan? For A I itu I X ini besar kanan ya, plus 1 ya. Ini min 1. Gimana sih, lupa Darren gimana? Kalau geser kiri itu berarti, kan ini kan berarti caps ya. Kan berarti kalau geser ke kanan, berarti kan ini 0, 1, 2, 3. Berarti kalau ini misalnya X, ini adalah A. So we have, this is X. This is A. We want it to be cats here. And then cats like here. Probably S will go here. Berarti kalau gitu kan ini indeksnya 0. Berarti 1 itu sebelumnya ya. Iya kan? Berarti dari 0. Oh, indeks 0 itu dari. Oke. Okay, dari min 1. Berarti salah. Berarti mulainya A-nya mulai dari 1, len X, minus 1, gini. Oke, gitu aja ya. Benar nggak? Berarti A posisi 0, A posisi I itu sama dengan yang sebelumnya. Kayak gini. Coba sekarang dipin. Berhasil nggak ada? Nanti masuk lagi. After this, oh, hah? Then tell me what's wrong. What's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong? We will just ignore this one because ya udahlah. Anggap ini nggak kehapus kan ya. This one is from the beginning. But why we have C, A, and then this is Y, S. Nati. Why? Why, Darren, why? Kan lengthnya dari, berarti kan lengthnya 4. 4 berarti kan 3. Berarti kan A-nya mulai dari 1. Oh, atau ini ya? Ini lengthnya biar aja. Lengthnya nggak usah dikurangin 1. Darren, tolongin. Oh, udah bener nih sekarang. Oke, okay, we got it right that now. Oke, okay. We done it. We did it. We have shifted it to the right. Okay. Berarti dia udah bisa dipakai, Darren. Copy this to your work. Copy this to your work. And then share me your screen. Okay, share me your screen, Darren. Make it work. Make it work on your work. On your replic. Okay, the number. Oh, okay. We still have like okay. We okay. Now we are on question number 12, right? 12, right? Okay, let me check. 12. Return the change step to the right with the last character removed. Okay. Ah, cuman beda kanan kiri aja. Eh, ini berhasil. Ya gitu boleh juga sih, Darren. That's a good idea. Actually, after I have a headache and then you just okay, that's smart. Iya ya, boleh juga sih gitu bisa. That's good, Darren. Now, okay. Acceptable. But if you wanted to do it the right way, the hard way, then do my way. Okay, number 15. We still have like 12 minutes. It's plenty of time. We still can do more. Return the number of times a lowercase e appears in the string. Okay, how do you find a letter in a string? Okay, I've seen this snippet here. Wait, pakai ini nggak sih, Darren? Bentar ya, ngecek appearance ya. Yang ini, Darren. Nih. This one. I'm sending you on the chat, okay? This part. If C in S, print. The first index of C in S is in the else. Print how many characters appears in a string? Print C appears C count C times in. Just follow the example, Darren. So you put it in between line 450 and line 51. Oh. Wow. I'm going to let you do your way, Darren. So because apparently you are smarter than me for the previous one, did it simpler than my way. Oh, I'm going to take a rest for a while. Yes, like that, Darren. Exactly. Yeah. How do we return this? We have to, Darren, else, the else, you have to, yes, it has to be in line with the if. Yes. Oh, dia nggak punya i ya? Wait, tadi disuruhnya apa ya? If gimana masukinnya ya? Kok susah sih? Kan C input, please type in C. Oh, atau gini aja, Darren. How about C equals to quotes E? We don't put input. Yeah, without input. Just equal it. Just rename, just assign it. Without, we don't need that. Yeah. Yes. Coba gitu bisa nggak? Hah, kok nggak ada? None. Hah? Six, tapi bener loh. 16, none. Return kali ya. Oh. Coba. Darren, return C. Return C. Atau return apa ya? Kita harus return sesuatu soalnya. We have to return something. C gitu? Or apa? Apa ya? Benar ya? Tapi yang disuruh how many times atau berapa sih Darren lihat soalnya? Let's take a look. Number of times. So you have to add this, Darren. Okay. Okay, you have to add the whole paragraph. The whole code I put on the chat. Okay, try it later. So we will just return C S dot count dot C. Return. Why did you put it on? Oh yeah, number 15, bener ya? Return of times a lowercase appear. Return s count c, return s dot count dot count and then in let me s dot count coba. Ah. Make sure the indentation is correct, Darren. Should this move a bit to the right, to the left, the C equals to E? Yes. One. Cuman satu gitu? Example. Oh, iya benar. Benar kan? Iya benar. Udah benar berarti. It's correct. Move on to the next. Right. Okay, number. Don't forget to submit, Darren. Don't forget to submit so we will save that. Okay, Darren. Nomor 16 apa gimana? How would you do it? Oh, yang besar sekarang ya. The capital. I'm going to delete this annotation. Itu bisa nggak ya? Okay, let's just try it. Probably working. Don't forget to return. Kok nggak clear sih? Clear all drawing. Let me show the instruction again, Darren, number. The instruction. Return number of lover of our case. Oh, okay. Bener kok if C in, oh, no. If C, no, no. If C in S. How about this? Give me the control there, and I'm going to change this one word. Okay, thank you. Boleh nggak ya gitu ya? Atau misalnya ini apalah dengan X gitu? Okay lah, X lah ya, X lah ya. Enggak dong. Return number of times a lower case. Oh, atau gini, Darren, we can do this if tapi ini tricky banget ya. Maksudnya this is not recommended, but it will work some way gitu. If C tapi tadi benar Darren juga ya, sini gitu ya. Bisa juga sih Darren, gitu ya. Ya, yeah, bisa bisa coba ya. Tak. Misalnya ini and ini nggak bisa ya. Let me see the instruction again. Return number of times of lower or uppercase E appear in the string. Alright. Tapi bener tadi ya, Darren bener ya. C E for C in S. Oh gitu. Ya udah, coba. Nggak bisa juga.
Coba menyampaikan yang recording tadi. Tadi mana ya, Darren?
If C in plain text. C in plain text. If for C. Oh. Wait. Darren. Okay. How about take a look at on the chat, Darren. How about we do it like this for C in if C for C for X in C. Tunggu-tunggu, Darren, taruh. Oke, gitu ya. Boleh nggak ya? Ini boleh nggak gini? We have, taruh. Darren pinjam dulu. Kalau gini, boleh nggak sih? Gini ya. Kalau nggak berhasil. If this doesn't work, we will continue next week. Oke, gini ya. If, terus kita tambahin. If, X in C, itu kan ya? Ya apalah pokoknya gitu ya. Four X in C. If X in S, print if this doesn't work, okay, we'll get sweet. Okay, and then the else would be there. And then like this. There, no, okay, return. Coba bisa nggak ya? It doesn't work. Okay, we'll think of another next week. Just remember that we have submit, Darren, submit. And then remember that we are on question number 16, okay? All right, submit. Yes, okay. At least we have done so many questions already. Okay, thanks so much. Sorry for the headache. See you next week, Darren. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.